हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द पार्ट टू वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5. सो एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट बोथ द जेंडर्स आर प्रेशराइज्ड बाय द सोसाइटी और बाय द फैमिली एंड बाय द फ्रेंड्स टू बिहेव what actually the boys do or what the girls do, this to behave the same. They cannot go against the things what is being already made or created in the society, that they have to follow the same thing. Like boys do not cry, the girls cannot opt the courses like becoming pilot, or they cannot become scientists, as they need high technical mind to just look after the thing. And girls are always having one aim in life, that is to get married. So this kind of many certain stereotype thinking that has to be followed by the society, and a certain kind of behavior which has to be followed by boys and girls. If it is not done, then they are being teased. Related to the same topic, we are having one of the story over here. See, Xavier was happy with the result of the class 10th board exams. Though his marks in science and maths were not high, he had done well in his favorite subject, that is history and languages. When his parents saw his report card, however, they did not look pleased at all, because where the technical mind, most probably it works with the boy or male gender, here he has not got the mark that much in maths and science, but in language subject he got the good marks. My goodness, Xavier, you have managed only 65% in maths. Your marks in physics are also too low. I know, Mama, but it's okay, because I don't want to take maths or science. I want to study history. So Xavier want to study history. He don't want to take maths and science. So he was not satisfied whatever mark he has got. Then the next question from his father itself: why do you want to take history? Think about your future. You have to get a good job. History will not help. It has no scope. So his father denied not to take the option of history, because there is no scope in future. But I don't like maths or science. So here Xavier don't like maths or science subject. So he is more interested in history than these other two subjects. So he replied to his father: be sensible, son, take maths and you can study computer side by side. The job market for computer is very good. So just father was having an experience. He was knowing more better than his son about the life and what to take or what to good or not. So he is suggesting his son to take maths and to learn computer, because it is having more scope compared to the history. So his future would be bright in future. So here you can find out the stereotype, how the subjects are also being chosen and how it is being related to the future. History is also having scope. You can become the architectural Inspector, you can become the archaeologist, like you can write down the history, you can read many things. So there is also scope. It is not like that after reading out the history there is no scope. He can become a teacher, he can become a professor also. So there are certain kind of scope, but this is not accepted by the family and friends, because they always opt science and maths to get a future better, to get a good salary. And even they, as the Xavier's father said, there is a job market if he is opting this subject. Learning for change. Now, going to school is an extremely important part of your life. As more and more children enter school every year, we begin to think that it is normal for all children to go to school. Today, it is difficult for us to imagine that school and learning could be seen as out of bounds or not appropriate for some children. But in the past, the skill of reading and writing was known to only a few. Most children learned the work their family or elders did. For girls, the situation was worse. In communities that taught sons to read and write, daughters were not allowed to learn the alphabet. Even in the families where skills like pottery, weaving and craft were taught, the contribution of daughters and women was only seen as supportive. For example, in the pottery trading, women collected the mud and prepared the earth for the pots. But since they did not operate the wheel, they were not seen as potters. In 19th century, many new ideas about education and learning emerged. Schools become more common, and communities that had never learned reading and writing started sending their children to school. But there was a lot of opposition to educating girls, and even then, yet many women and men made efforts to open schools for girls. Women struggled, learned to read and write. So let us read about the experience of Rasundri Devi. She was born in 1800 and died in 1890, who was born in West Bengal some 200 years ago. At the age of 60, she wrote her autobiography in Bangla. Her book titled Amar Jeevan is the first known autobiography written by an Indian woman. Rasundri Devi was a housewife from a rich landlord family. At that time, it was believed that if a woman learned to read and write, she would bring bad luck to her husband and become a widow. Despite this, she taught herself how to read and write in secret well after her marriage. I would start working at dawn and would still be at it until well beyond midnight. I had no rest in between. I was only 14 years old at the time. I came to nurture a great longing. I would learn to read, and I would read a religious manuscript. I was unlucky in those days. Women were not educated. Later I began to resent my own thought. What is wrong with me? Women do not read about. How will I do it? Then I had a dream. I was reading the manuscript of Chaitanya Bhagavat, the life of a saint. Later in the day, I sat cooking in the kitchen. I heard my husband saying to my eldest son, Bipin, I have left my Chaitanya Bhagavat here. When I asked for it, bring it in. He left the book there and went away. When the book had been taken inside, I secretly took out a page and hid it carefully. It was a job hiding it, for nobody must find it in my hands. My eldest son was practicing his alphabet at that time. I hid one of them as well, and at the time I went over that, trying to match letters from the page with the letters that I remembered. I also tried to match the words with those that I would hear in course of my days. With tremendous care and effort, and over a long period of time, I learned how to read. After learning the alphabet, Rasundri Devi was able to read the Chaitanya Bhagavat. Through her own writing, she also gave the world an opportunity to read about women's lives in those days. Rasundri Devi wrote about her everyday life experiences in details. There were days when she did not have moments, rest, no time even to sit down and eat. So here one case study was about the Rasundri Devi. Before that, we will understand the conditions in the past about the male and the female, how the learning came into change. So going to the school, that was an important task right now in the present situation of your life. Without school, you cannot imagine your life, because as a child, or you are always going to school up to certain ages, up to whenever you are getting degree. So up to that, you are going to school and colleges. But this was not the same condition in the past. Not everyone were having the opportunity to get into the school or to just imagine school life. Because in the past, there was only few who were studying, like various varnas were there, Brahman, Kshatriyas, Shudras and Vaishyas. So most probably the Kshatriyas and the Brahmans. So Brahmans usually learns various kind of Vedas and texts, and Kshatriya also learned, but only whatever like Shastra Vidya's books and how to tackle war. So this kind of study they were learning. So everyone was not learned, only the few one were learned that time. They were going to school, not everyone. But in present situation, we all are going school, like both the genders. Now, if we talk about the past, as I said, in few, there also the male were allowed to learn things. The female were not allowed. The girls were not allowed to go to the school or learn anything. So in many communities, the sons were taught to read and write. Daughters were not even allowed to learn the alphabet. In many families, here one example is given, like the pottery weaving, craft work were taught to both. But contribution of daughter, it would be very less. So they are not getting the title like weaver or potter. Here this example says, like when it is about the work of pottery, then again we are always seeing the men doing the job. But to bring the ingredients, the needed things to make a pot, that is being brought by the woman itself. They are collecting mud and preparing the earth by what the pot has to be made. But as she is not operating the wheel, she is not counted as an potter. So pottery work is always being done by the men, as he is operating the wheel. So in 19th century, many new ideas about education and learning emerged. So school become more common to the both the gender and as well as community. They started reading, writing, and also started sending their children, like both the genders, to the school. So it is not complete, you cannot say the 100% girls were going to school. Many were against to send the girl child to the school. That was against the community, when many were not accepting these things and they were opposing it, to send the girls for education. But though they were facing this kind of problems, many of the men made efforts to make schools for the girls, and even the women also struggled to learn read and write. So one such case was about the Rasundri Devi, as we have learned about her, that she was born in 1800 and died by 1890. So her story is about 200 years ago. At the age of 60, she has written her autobiography, that also in which language? Bangla. And the title of her autobiography was Amar Jeevan. So this was the first written autobiography, non-written autobiography that was being written by any Indian woman. So she was the first. Rasundri Devi, she was a housewife to a rich landlord family. And at that time, it was believed that if woman learned to read and write, then she would bring a bad luck and even she could become widow. So her husband could die. So these were the superstitious belief what was being followed in the past times, and for that reason the girls were not allowed to read and write. Despite of all these things, she taught herself to read and write in secret. So there were no teachers to teach her how to read and write. After her marriage, she secretly taught herself to read and write. She is stating about her that early in the morning, in the dawn, it means around 4 o'clock, she used to wake up, and till midnight she used to do work, all kind of work. And in between that time, she used to taught herself to read and write. So she was only 14 at that time. And just imagine your life and compare it with the Rasundri Devi. At the age of 14, you are enjoying your life by playing, studying, watching TVs and doing certain kind of activities. But here, she was got married. She was looking after the family, all kind of household work, and waking up early in the morning, sleeping by midnight, and then she is teaching herself to read and write, means self-taught. She read, mainly she is reading out the religious main manuscripts, and as she was unlucky in those days, women were not educated. Later on, this resent her own thought that we should be educated, like the women's should be educated. What is wrong with me? Woman do not read, how will I do it? If I am reading, then whether it would bring bad luck to the family or not. So all this kind of thought came on her mind. But one night she dreamt, and she was reading out a manuscript of Chaitanya Bhagavat. So that was the book related to the life of a saint. Later on, after a few days, she was just sitting in the kitchen and cooking. And meanwhile, she heard her husband saying to his eldest son and his eldest son name was Bipin, that he has left Chaitanya Bhagavat over there. Whenever he asks, his father asks, then to give him back. So she went there secretly, took a page from that book, and keeping that also was an one kind of job only to hiding it, because if anyone sees that if she is having the page of that book and she is going to read out that, it means that was a big thing in the family, that she will bring bad luck or she can become a widow. This was the thought of that time. So secretly she hid the pages in many different places, and at that time her eldest son Bipin was learning the alphabets. So she was also hearing the same thing. So whatever eldest son has learned the alphabet, she used to recognize that letter. She compared that letter to that paper, whatever she has collected and hidden, and she connect all that letters together and just read out and tries to read out the same word whatever she has heard in the day to day. Compare both the words, and like this she has self-taught her how to read the thing. And she has read the whole book, that is Chaitanya Bhagavat. So she read the whole book by self-taught herself. and that was the greatest achievement ever she had. As now she came to know how to read and write, later on she also given the opportunity to other to know about her also, like the woman's lives also. She written the day-to-day, everyday's life experiences and shared each and everything in detail. She written everything and so everything this was being done without any kind of rest, as she was has to look after her children also and the household work, looking after the family members and even just teaching herself and writing down the stuff. So even she was not getting time to eat also. But going through all this hardship, she has completed her book at the age of 60. You just imagine, by 14 she has learning herself and teaching herself, and by 60, at the age of 60, she completed book. She has written the autobiography that was known as Amar Jeevan. So that was a great achievement. One thing was left over here, the same starting of the page. See here, you can see one more example of one woman. Her name was Ramabai. She born in 1858 and died by 1922. Shown above with her daughter. So Ramabai and her daughter, you can see in the picture. Championed the cause of women's education. She never went to school but learned to read and write from her parents. So she was learning it from her parents. And Rashundri Devi, she has self-taught her. And she was given the title of Pandita because she could read and write Sanskrit, a remarkable achievement as women then were not allowed such knowledge. So learning something, that was the great deal at that time. But though she has faced many of the problems, she learned the Sanskrit language, that the most probably this language is always learned by the Brahmanas. So as she has learned this Sanskrit, so she got the title as Pandita. She went on set up a mission in Khedagaon near Pune in 1898, where widows and poor women were encouraged not only to become literate but to be independent. So widows and poor women were allowed to learn, and they were encouraged to learn and to live independently. They were taught a variety of skills, from carpentry to running a printing press, skills that are not usually taught to girls even today. So she was teaching printing, to run printer, and as well as the carpentry skills. Most probably these jobs are being opted by the men, but she taught this to the women. The printing press can be seen in the picture on the top left corner. Ramabai's mission is still alive today. So the same thing still it is going on, the printing press still it is led by the women. You can see the printing press over here. All the working hands are women itself. One more thing and example, that was about the Rokaya Sakhawat Hossain and her dreams about Ladyland, that we are going to cover in the next video. Till then, whatever topic we have completed, complete the worksheet up to there. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you.